Hello, my honeys, it's Emmy. If you're new to the channel, welcome. My name is Emmy. I'm a nutritionist and the creator of the Slim on Starch program. If you want to work with me as well as a mindset coach and a nutrition coach, go to healthyemmy.org or just click the link in the down bar. If you want the secret sauce to lose weight on the starch solution for maximum weight loss, then watch this video because I'm going to be pulling back the curtain and sharing with you the top five secret hacks that one of my most successful clients, Kristen, used during our work together. Kristen went from this to this. So as you can see, she definitely knew what she was doing, and I want to tell you how you can do exactly what she did, starting with number five and working our way down to the number one thing that you must do if you want to get results like Kristen. Starting at number five, Kristen trusted me 100%, and she trusted this process 100%. When Kristen came to me, she said, "I have nothing left to lose. I have tried everything, so I may as well give my all to this. What do I have to lose?" And as Dr. McDougall says, this lifestyle works for 100% of people that do it 100% of the time. So unless you are a robot or you defy the laws of thermodynamics, this will work for you, but it requires you to jump right in and to trust and to surrender to this process. We can't think our way into acting. We can only act our way into thinking, which means that there's nothing that I can say to you to make you believe that this can work for you. You have to do it and get the results. Let's say that there's a little kid who's standing on a ledge in front of you and they're gonna jump into your arms and you say, "I can catch you, don't worry, I can catch you." The kid's not gonna believe it until they are in your arms. Then they will believe that you're gonna catch them if they jump off of that ledge. But they have to take a leap of faith and trust that you are going to catch them. And if you don't trust that this is going to work, then this is not going to work. You have to jump in before you're ready, trust this process 100%. And the reason why I bring this up specifically with Kristen's case is because Kristen's weight actually went up during week one, but I prepared her for this. I said, "Kristen, your weight is likely going to jump up during week one because you've been on a restrictive diet, eating low carbohydrates. It's not abnormal for this to happen, but I promise you it is going to go down. This initial jump is just a reflection of increased glycogen stores and water weight. So let's be prepared for it. It's going to happen, but hold on tight. I got you. It's going to go down afterward." And because she understood that this was a process that she was playing the long game for and not the short game, and that she trusted me, she knew this was going to work, she held on and she kept going. She even talks about this in our interview together, which you can see in the description bar. I'll link it so you can watch the whole interview after you watch this full video. But please watch this full video because there's a lot of gems in here. Kristen also realized that asking for help was a sign of self-awareness and self-respect. Many people are hesitant to ask for help because they think, "Why can't I do it by myself? What is wrong with me? Why aren't I capable enough?" But the people that come to me that ask for help are the people that inspire me the most, because these are nurses, they're doctors, they're therapists, they're teachers, they're moms, they're daughters, they're wives, they're husbands. These are people that I admire that have so much on their plates. And the fact that they're coming to me and asking for help shows that they know their importance in their lives. They know that their whole family can't exist unless they're the best mother and wife that they can be. So asking for help shows me that they care about their role as a mother and a wife and a husband and a boyfriend and a daughter, whatever role they have, and understand that in order to be operating at the highest capacity, they've got to be an A+ in their health. So when people come to me and ask for help, I see I have massive respect for these people because they understand the weight that they hold and how important their health is to the happiness and health of the rest of their family. The second thing that Kristen did was she was willing to be open, honest, and vulnerable. There's a saying that secrets keep us sick. And if we stick our head in the sand and we don't face the things that we know we need to take care of, they're gonna stay with us forever. What we run from only stays with us longer. And the fact that Kristen was so open, so honest, and she was willing to say to me, and she says this in her interview as well, "I would sit in my room with the lights off and just eat food." The fact that she said that out loud is what got it out of her. Sometimes I'm speaking with clients and I can tell that they're being a little reserved about some behavior or some mindset or some pattern that they've got themselves into, to which I say, "I have literally heard it all. There's nothing that somebody could say to me about their relationship with food that I have not heard before. So say it. This is what I'm here for. This is what the mindset coaches are here for. This is what the nutrition coaches are here for. And if you're not working with me and you're working with somebody else, that's what they are here for. There are people here who can help you and who want to help you. And you letting it out is so necessary to making progress. And if it's not saying it to me, perhaps it's saying it to a loved one or somebody that you trust. But whatever it is that you're struggling with, you have to let it out. The only way to disconnect from that behavior and from that mindset is to verbalize it and get it out of you. Talk about it, get it out, and leave it disconnected from you. And the fact that Kristen was so open, so honest, and so vulnerable was what allowed her to talk through the things that she was experiencing, disconnect herself from them, and look at it as Kristen and the behavior, as opposed to Kristen is the person that does the behavior. Why can't she get a hold of this? And that is who she is. Separating her identity from that behavior was so important, and the way to do it was being totally open, honest, and vulnerable. I have so much compassion for individuals that struggle with weight or body image or food, whatever it is. I have done a lot of study on addiction. I've seen a lot of addiction in my personal life and have come to recognize that addiction, issues with food, issues with weight are not a reflection of the individual whatsoever, but they're a reflection of what the human system does when it's under certain circumstances, certain environments, and certain stresses. I've seen what addiction can do to people and can make people act in ways that are not reflective of who they are, what their souls are, what their intentions are. And the same thing happens with food. People say, Emmy, I'm the CEO of a company, and here I am stopping at Taco Bell on my way home, shoving my face after giving a meeting, or I'm an attorney and I just made partner, and then on the way home I stop at McDonald's and I stuff my face with food. I feel like I live this double life. There's so much shame that comes along with it. But there's no emotions that we need to associate with these behaviors that you're engaging in, because they're biological responses to the fact that you're restricting yourself from food or that you're getting a certain high from food. This is what the system does in response to the conditions that it's been under. So it is not a reflection of who you are, what your desires are, what your soul is. You did not ask for the struggles that you're going through. What makes you unique is the fact that you are going to ask for help for the struggles that you did not put upon yourself, that are a reflection of a system, a human system, that is under stress with certain circumstances. So please, let's drop the shame. There is no shame that needs to be involved in this, and really no emotions whatsoever that should be involved with the biological response that you are engaging in through an addiction to food or an emotional reliance on food. It really is a biological response. Let's drop the emotions and be totally upfront and honest about what you're going through. No judgment whatsoever. By the way, if you are enjoying this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. It really, really supports my channel. Number three, Kristen was committed to playing the long game. As I mentioned earlier in this video, her weight went up in week one. And I said, Kristen, this might happen, but I promise it is going to go back down. We often see this, that weight will spike a little bit in week one as you're eating larger quantities of food, your glycogen stores are increased, your water weight might be up a little bit, but it's going to go back down. And Kristen took a telescope approach as opposed to a microscope approach. So she wasn't a scale monkey that was watching the scale day to day. Instead, she zoomed out the lens. She looked at this from a Google Earth point of view, overlooked everything and said, okay, this might happen in week one, but I know that in week two, it's going to keep going back down. And she kept going. She did not blink. She did not bat an eyelash. She just kept going with what she was doing. And naturally the weight came back down. Number two is so, so important. And it's that Kristen did not listen to any other podcasts or doctors or influencers or what I eat in a day videos. All she focused on was her work, and in the case with me being inside my program and working with me, her work in the program. There's so much contradicting information out there. You'll even see doctors in the plant-based world who will disagree and argue with one another, which I think is so crazy because we're all on the same team here. So I don't know if it's wrapped up in ego or what it is, but this is so, it's so heartbreaking for me to watch the person with such pure intentions who they say, Emmy, I'm really trying to get as much information as I can about this plant-based lifestyle. So I'm going to watch all these podcasts. I'm going to watch all these What I Eat in a Day videos. And then they start to recognize, wait a minute, that's a little bit different than what I do. Wait a minute, that piece of information is different than the one that Emmy told me to do. And it's a source of confusion. So the first thing to do is to unsubscribe from everybody else, unfollow everybody else, at least temporarily, so that you can laser focus, or mute them for the moment if you don't want to unfollow, or just don't look at their videos at the moment or their posts, and just laser focus on what you are doing. Put up those boundaries, put up those blinders. This is about you and your journey. Nobody on this planet knows what you need as well as you do. Nobody knows what it's like to be in your shoes, what you feel like, what your energy is like at the moment. So don't listen to what all of these other people are saying and really hone in on your journey. What this also allowed Kristen to do is what I would consider an honorable mention of this video, was dig into her primary foods. We talk so much about primary foods in the program, the things outside of food that bring you joy. And for a lot of the people that I work with, they've spent so much time researching recipes and food and what I eat in a day videos that that's all they know. If you pull up their podcasts on their phone or if you go on their YouTube channel, everything is food and weight loss and nutrition related. And I say, well, what are you interested in? What do you like to spend your free time doing? And they say, listening to podcasts about nutrition or watching videos about weight loss. And that's all they know. And for most people that I work with, this is the case. So if you're watching this video thinking, oh my God, Emmy is speaking to me right now. I'm speaking to a lot of people. It's not just you that experiences this. And I say this because you are not alone. If you feel any shame about that, that you don't know what your passions are outside of food and weight loss and health. But now it's time for us to discover this. For Kristen, it was fashion. Fashion was her big, huge primary food. She would post all these photos and all of these different outfits that she was wearing from all these different decades. And it was so beautiful to see that part of her life come back to life, something that she used to love. So really engaging in what lights you up outside of food is gonna be extremely important to your journey. And the number one thing that Kristen did in order to find success and long-term success at that was her emphasis on community. We have a support group and she posted in that group every single day. In our work together, she was so present. She asked so many questions. She always listened to her check-in. She responded back with questions. She was so active in the community. And humans are social animals. We can't do things alone. We can do things alone, but just because you could do something doesn't mean that you should do something. And humans are social creatures. We rely on one another. We live in families. We lived in villages in the caveman days. We're not meant to do things on our own. We are not independent animals. We are social animals. And even if you're an introvert watching this, which a lot of the people on the YouTube watch screen are, I would consider myself an introvert as well, it doesn't keep us from being social creatures that need support in order to be successful. Again, like I said earlier in this video, asking for help is a sign of self-awareness and self-respect, and community is one of the most rewarding parts of asking for help because you realize you're not alone and there are people here that want you to succeed. Alcoholics Anonymous actually started, there was this theory that these two men went up to this woman whose husband was struggling. This is an old wives' tale. The husband was struggling with alcoholism, and these two men went up to the wife and they said, we found the cure for alcoholism and we want your husband to be a part of it. Can we help him? And she said, oh my gosh, absolutely. I have tried everything. Please help my husband. And so they started mentoring him, and they themselves were sober from alcohol. And she said, what's the magic here? How does this work? And they said, well, actually, by helping him, he helps us. And that's how Alcoholics Anonymous was created, was the mentorship, and helping others is what helps you. Sometimes the best way to help yourself is to help others and see what they're going through is a reflection of something that you are going through as well. And you give advice to somebody else and you go, actually, that's really good advice that I should probably take myself. So community is so helpful in this journey and was one of the pillars to Kristen's success. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want results like Kristen with her before and after, then please click the link in the down bar, apply to work with me, and I'll see you in my next video. Woo!